era esattamente il mio obiettivo, offrirvi la possibilità di compiere una piccola rivoluzione nella vostra testa, riorganizzando i saperi che queste persone vi stanno proponendo. Un visionario coraggioso, un influente imprenditore sociale, a voi signori, Bankhead Roy.
Whatever you think or whatever you felt about development, I'm going to give you a completely different perception. I went to a very, very expensive school and college in India. And in 1965, I went to a village for the first time and it changed my life. And I came back home and I told my mother that, you know, I'd like to live and work in a village. Something hit me in the village and I'd like to go back and contribute. There's something that I want to give back to society. She wouldn't speak to me for many years. The only time she actually accepted me was when the Prince and Princess of Wales came to Thelonia for the first time. The Barefoot College is 500 kilometers southwest of Delhi, and it's a place which is the only college built by the poor, run by the poor, and managed by the poor. And the first thing the poor told me was, please, give knowledge, skill, wisdom, more importance than paper qualifications. It's a place where we have a very different definition of professional. A professional is someone who has a combination of competence, confidence, and belief. So we built the Barefoot College with barefoot architects who still can't read and write today. But they built my college at $1.50 a square foot. And it is the only college in India where we have only used barefoot architects. It is the only college in India which is fully solar energized. For the next 25 years, I have no problem with water and power, even though it is in the middle of Rajasthan where it sometimes does not rain for 5 years. And it was built by someone who's done only 8 years of primary schooling. Everyone sits on the floor, eats on the floor, works on the floor. No one comes for the money as much as for the challenge. No one is allowed to get more than $100 a month, even if you stay there for 30 years, because the money is not as important. 60% of the children in India can't go to school in the morning because they look after goats and cattle and sheep. So we try and see that we start a school for night. The night schools of Thelonia are for children who can't go to school in the morning, but they go to school at night. But the most important thing is that we teach the children democracy, citizenship, responsibility. So every 3 years, 7,000 children between ages 6 and 14 elect a prime minister. The prime minister today is 12 years old. She looks after 20 goats in the morning, but she's prime minister in the evening. The beauty is that we have actually spread this whole demystification, decentralized, solar electrified village approach outside India. We took the barefoot approach to Africa. 21 countries in Africa have got the barefoot approach. We've trained about 140 mothers. But what we are doing is we are only training grandmothers. We are not training men. Men are ambitious, men are restless, and men want a certificate. The women, rooted to the soil, patient, tolerant, compassionate, and willing to learn, and they will not leave. The only reason why we don't give certificates after training is that they leave. The moment you hand a certificate in the hand of any man in Africa, within 24 hours, he'll leave his village and go to a city looking for a job. A woman will never do that. We don't allow the World Bank or the UN to come into the Barefoot College because they've got nothing to tell us that we don't know already. Look at the tremendous knowledge and skills that very poor people have that are unutilized, unrecognized today. Where is it written that just because you can't read and write, you cannot become a teacher, a verbal, oral teacher, or a doctor, or a designer, or a computer expert? School is what you learn how to read and write. Education is what you get from your family, your environment, and your community. I will stop with a quotation from Gandhi. He said, first they ignore you, then they laugh at you, then they fight you, and then you win.
Il momento in cui ha detto io voglio stare nel villaggio, ha affermato di aver riscoperto, ritrovato i suoi valori più intimi e profondi. Ed è nata l'Università degli Scalzi, dove chiunque, una nonna, può imparare a diventare un ingegnere e a fare i pannelli solari in un tempo straordinariamente breve e a produrre ricchezza non solo per se stessa, ma per la comunità nella quale vive. Tutti noi dipendiamo da qualcosa, da qualcuno. Tutti siamo legati da un vincolo di interdipendenza che non potrà mai essere sciolto. Ha recuperato un sapere tradizionale e di nuovo troviamo una relazione diretta tra maestro e discepolo. Infatti questo sapere viene tramandato da nonna a nipote, che a sua volta diventa una nonna, che ha nipoti a cui sussurrare nell'orecchio si fa così. Era bellissimo il passaggio delle donne che non volevano gli uomini perché non volevano far sapere loro il segreto di come si costruisce un tetto a tenuta d'acqua. No? È fantastico questa dimensione di clan. Ruolo, una parola magica, ruolo. Se io riesco a comprendere qual è il mio ruolo, io riesco a capire qual è la mia responsabilità. Se so qual è la mia responsabilità, posso dire a me stesso come potrò servire il mondo.